Hi everybody, it is me, and it's been a while. I know, I haven't done a video in seems like forever. It's probably been a month, I don't know. Anyway, I have been keeping busy. I've been knitting as usual. what else am I gonna do? My husband's been away. He's been on a hiking trip over in Europe to the Swiss and French Alps. And he's been having a great time. This week he was in London, and he'll be home tomorrow. 3 weeks I had, by myself, and it's over already. And where's the camera? Okay, I gotta, I forget which way to look. Okay, anyway, he's had a great time. He's been sending great pictures, and but anyway, he's gonna be back tomorrow. I thoroughly enjoyed my time by myself. The house was quiet. Of course, I have a dog and two cats, and they required a lot of my time and are very demanding. Every night after dinner, I go sit down on the couch, and as soon as I sit down, Scooter's there acting like he wants to play, but he doesn't want to play. He wants a biscuit. So I have to go get him a treat. It's become a evening ritual, right after dinner or as soon as I sit down in the living room to watch TV. My animals are overdue for their shots. I'm taking Scooter to the vet later today in about an hour and a half, taking him to the vet. He's overdue for his rabies shots and all his other boosters, although he's 11 years old now, so I'm going to talk to the vet about not getting all those shots, just what's required by law, which is the rabies, Anyways, other stuff that's been happening, I met with my, yesterday, my son, Mike, my older son, came up with Lawrence after school, and, he had to bring back the lawnmower. He borrowed our lawnmower, and we went to dinner, had a great time. It was great. It's nice to eat out during the week, because usually I cook all week long, and we go out to eat Friday and Saturday nights, and then I cook Sunday through Thursday. And I have been cooking while my husband has been gone. It wasn't as challenging as I thought. I can cook for one, and I cooked pretty decent stuff. Bell peppers, ribs and beans, and spaghetti even one night, and pork chops, and I did a couple of crock pot things, and it wasn't hot dogs every night. One thing that happened to me, in Texas they require you to have a front license plate. I don't have a license plate on the front of my car. I've been driving my car for almost 6 years now, and I have never had the plate put on the front because it doesn't have a place for it. To put it on there, I would have to have holes drilled in it, and I just didn't want to do that. So anyway, all of a sudden, I get stopped twice in 1 week. Because I don't have my license plate on. So yesterday, or the day before yesterday, I stopped up the street at a place to see about getting my car inspected, because on the 31st was also the last day of August that my inspection was due. We have to get our cars inspected here every year. Well, they've changed it now. Now you don't need an inspection sticker, but you do need to get it still inspected, but you get it done at the time you need to register your car. And that registration is also renewable yearly. And so the guy told me I didn't need to get it inspected until December. So he said, just scrape off the old inspection sticker. And he said, because they're not giving you tickets for that. And I said, well, I don't know. I've been pulled over twice in 1 week for the license plate. I said, would you charge me to put my license plate on? He said, I don't know. I said, great. Well, can you put it on for me? He said, sure. I'm busy with this lady. As soon as I get done with her, I'll do it for you. I said, great. So I pulled over to the side, and I'm waiting and waiting and waiting. Well, 15, 20 minutes go by, and he's still busy. A few more cars have come in the meantime. And so I start to leave, and he comes over, and he says, I said, well, you're busy. I'll just come back another time. And he said, well, I was discussing it with my manager, and We just don't know. We looked up the specs for your car, and we just don't know where we would put it. We'd have to drill holes, and we don't feel comfortable doing that. I said, me either, which is why it's not on there. So anyway, I do have to take my car in for service. It's overdue for that. I'm overdue with everything. And I'll just have them put it on if they don't charge me anything. If they're going to charge me, I'll just have my husband do it. So anyway, yesterday I went to the bank. Now, I haven't been to our bank in probably a couple of years other than up to the ATM. Mainly because it's just out of the way. It's all the way. It's about 10 miles away from me. And they don't have one closer or even an ATM for their bank that's closer. So it's a pain, and I never have cash, and it's awful. So anyway, since my husband's been out of town, some checks have come in that I had to go deposit. And so yesterday I went to the bank. And was it yesterday? Yeah. No, it was Monday. I went Monday. Went to the bank. And first I go to the drive-thru. Well, I only see two green lights for, you know, that the bay is open. And then there were a couple of other places in the drive-thru that said commercial. So I figured they were for business. So I went to the first couple, you know, got into one that only had two other people ahead of me. And I got in that line. And I'm waiting and waiting. And then I realized that I'm at an ATM drive-up or drive-through, an ATM, rather than a teller thing where you send a thing in the tube and it goes to the teller inside the bank. So I go to put it in reverse to back up and get out of there and go in one of the other lines, and somebody pulls in behind me. So now I'm trapped. So I had to sit there and wait, and the person in front of me took forever. So, you know, I'm already in a bad mood because every time I've been to this bank, it takes a long time. So anyway, they finally finished, and I pulled through, and I went around to the front, and I parked, and I go inside. Well, there's like 8 people in line, and 1 teller is open. Ridiculous. And, you know, at the teller windows, they have their counter, and then they have this plexiglass or some kind of a glass walls up in front of them, and they have this little teeny opening this big in front of them to where you put your check or whatever, your deposit slip or whatever you have, and slide it into them. It looks like Fort Knox. I mean, it's crazy. I guess it's protection for robberies or something. I don't know, but it's not very friendly. So anyway, I had to wait a really long time. Another teller that was for, it said merchant business or something. And so I figured that was for businesses too. Nobody was going to that line. But then she came to that window and she motioned over for somebody and they finally went. So then they had 2 tellers, but it was ridiculous. So when I left, I got a blank deposit slip, and on the back wrote 8 to 10 people in line and 1 teller serving them or at the window. Ridiculous. And I left it on the counter where people that need help with one of the bankers, you know, have to sign in. So they're always checking that. So I hope they got the message. You know, it's ridiculous. I mean, even Walmart will open another register when you get 3 or 4 people in line. You know, 8 to 10 people. There was 9 people at one point in line waiting, and each person was took a long time, obviously didn't just have a deposit or something. And I don't know, it was crazy. Frustrating. That's the way I tried to do my banking online. I do most of my banking online. And you can take pictures of your checks to deposit them, but one was over a certain amount and I didn't know what the limit was for being able to do that. So I didn't do it. So anyway, I was timing it. I was timing how long I was talking on here, and then my watch just went blank and it's not up anymore. So I don't know how long I've been talking. I tend to ramble on. Anyway, that's enough of the news. I did get some buttons for the baby sweater that I knit. Oh wait, where is it? I don't even have it out here. Anyway, I have it. I put it away. I got some little buttons. I'll have to show you them another time. But anyway, I went to my yarn store and, of course, had to get other yarn. I saw this sweater. I love this sweater. I used to see it all the time. Well, none of my kids liked it. So then I saw this on the back and I thought, well, you know what? That's cute because, you know, each stripe is all that is a it's a garter stitch, a purl stitch rib on this sweater that just makes that design. And it's just so cute. So since I'm having a little girl, I got this yarn. It's white and it has the pink and the blue and the purple and the yellow little speckles in it. So I got this to do the body of the sweater. And I'm going to do the stripes in just this pink. And this is Plymouth Yarn. What's it? Plymouth Yarn Dream Baby DK. And, you know, each one is like $4 or something. So I'm going to make that little sweater. I just think it's adorable. And I can also, I got enough to also make the hat. So I'm going to make the hat. I just love it. They have one knitted up in the store. And it just is so cute. And I just love it. Of course, you know, I love all the bright colors and stuff, you know. Anyway. So instead, I got this. This is called, what's it called? Lang Yarns, I don't know, J-Wall color. Anyway, it's a striping yarn, and I'm going to make some socks for me with all these colors. Does it say a color on here besides that J-Wall? It's a superwash. It's a superwash wool. It's 75% virgin wool and 25% nylon. Doesn't say what that color is. Oh, and look, inside comes with this. It's a little spool of thread that you use when you're knitting the heel to reinforce it. I thought that was so cool. So you get a little bonus. So anyway, some socks. I also bought some other sock yarn, which I cannot show you because they are going to be for my sister, in case she watches my podcast. Not my podcast, in case she watches this video. I've been watching a lot of knitting podcasts, which is why I said that. The other thing I did, I made these little socks for my daughter-in-law, and I already mailed them to her, and she loves them. They fit her. And they are great. I'm currently making some for my other daughter-in-law. She picked out this yarn that I had in my stash, so I'm using up my stash. And I made her the same kind. And these are called the Something City Rollers. What are they called? Kansas City Rollers? I'm not sure what they're called, but anyway, the pattern calls for a rolled top on it. Instead, I put a ribbing at the top, so they're just little ankle socks. I didn't wash it yet or anything, but this is her sock, and I am working on the second one. I just finished the heel turn. I'm at the gusset part, and then I'll be doing the foot, so that's her sock. I'm also at the same time working on, you remember I showed you this sock that I just loved. I love this pattern. It's just a slip stitch pattern. It's just so cool. I finally did cast on for the second one. So I'm at the leg part of it. So I'm working on that. I trade them off. You know, I work an hour on this one, and then I work an hour on that one, and then I'm working on a baby blanket. Two, actually. One I had to totally frog last night, meaning took it off the needles and trashed it. I have to start over. This is one blanket I'm making. It's with a cotton yarn. It is so cool. I love it. I just love how it feels, and it's going to feel even better once it's washed. I don't know which side is which. I don't think it really matters. But anyway, it has the pink and the purple and then the white, and then it's pink and white, pink and white, pink and white until you get to near the end, and then you do another row of the purple and then another row of the pink to finish it. So I've been working on that one, and that one's going good. And the other blanket, I think I told you about it. It's called the Tree of Life. Here is a picture of it. I don't know how well you'll be able to see it, the design. But that's the Tree of Life baby blanket that I'm going to make. Well, I cast it on, and I got about this far, about 25 rows into the tree pattern, into this first panel of the trees. And I got up to, you know, a little past where the branches are starting, about that far. And I put it down, and I hadn't been working on it in a few days. And then last night I went to work on it again, yesterday afternoon, and I did one row. And somehow at the end of the row, I ended up with too many stitches. Like, I should have only had 4 left. I had 8 left. So somewhere I made a mistake. So I started unknitting that row. And because it has cables in it, and I didn't get it unknitted right. So I got so frustrated. So I just ripped the whole thing out, and I'm going to start all over again. I really love the yarn. It's this. It's a, well, you know, I wound all but one, and I put the other one away. I wound them all up. So what the ball band is for these, I don't think I have it written down. And I don't think I have it in the bag. No, I don't. So anyway, but it's a great yarn. Oh, wait, here's a ball band. I can tell you what it is. I think it's vintage. It's Barocco Vintage. It's a machine washable blend, and actually it's 52% acrylic, 40% wool, and 8% nylon, and it's going to make a great baby blanket. And with that pattern, you know, it's just going to be so nice. So I can't wait to get back working it, but I'm telling you, you know, I mean, it has charts, and I had to put it on a magnetic board. This is the chart, and I don't like following charts. So luckily, it has it all written out here, which is what I'm following. But I'm also looking up here. I think if I would look up there for the row that is just knit the knits and purl the pearls on the back side, I think I would do a little bit better. So I'm working on that. So I've got, you know, a bunch of stuff going all at once. All those blankets, 2 blankets. I finished the one sweater. I've got another sweater I want to make. I got 2 pairs of socks on the needles. I still have my Arabella shawl. I still have my, what's that other one? Oh, I want to say handbrake, but it's not the handbrake. It's the, you know. What is that? My mind is gone. It's gone. And but anyway, I'm still working on that. I have the fingerless mitts I'm still working on. Haven't touched them. I still have a cowl from like 2 years ago that I started and never finished. Got to finish that. I have so many things on the needles and so many more things I want to knit. So that's what's taken up all my time, knitting. That's about it. So, I guess that catches you up with what I've been busy doing. So, I got 2. My grandson's Brighton, he started kindergarten this year and is doing so good. He's also playing flag football, and my son also had him registered for Indian Guides, and their first camp out is later this month. So that's going to be so great. All 3 of my sons went to Indian Guides, and then Boys Cub Scouts, and then Boy Scouts. And I think it's really great for kids, for boys, and for girls to go into Girl Scouts, Brownies, whatever. I think it's good for them. Anyway, I think probably Boy Scouts is, well, I don't know. You know, it's been a long time since I had a child that was Boy Scout age. So I was going to say that it's kind of fading away, but, you know, maybe not. I just don't have kids at that age. But now that I have grandsons that are getting up there, maybe. So we'll see if Lawrence gets into anything like that. He's probably going to play soccer again. He's in second grade. Can you believe that? Second grade. He reads so well. He comes over and he's always reading things for me. He loves to do that. He reads his own menu. He orders his own dinners when we go out. And it's really funny. It's really cute. And then we've got Cole, who he's also five, but he's a late, he has a late birthday. It's in August and right at the beginning of the school year. And with boys, you know, they tend to be a little slower than girls. Although I think Cole is highly intelligent, and I really didn't agree with what his mom is doing. But, you know, what can I say? Anyway, she's keeping him in pre-K for another year. And then he's going to start kindergarten next year. So he'll be one of the older kids in his class. And, but anyway, we'll see. Hopefully he won't be too bored this year because he is really smart. And we'll see how this goes. So, but anyway, I can't wait. I might get to see him this weekend. That would be good. I saw Lawrence yesterday. And Sunday, they came over for dinner. And let's see what else. Of course, I talk to Brighton and Ephraim all the time on FaceTime. We do that. We try to do it at least once a week. And Ephraim is so cute. He's walking and he's becoming a kid now. You know, he's not a baby. He's a kid. He's, I don't know, 15, 16 months old. His birthday's in April. Anyway, he's getting big, and the new baby's born at Christmas, and moving out, moving up. So that's about it. Another hot day here. I'm sure it's probably 90-something. I don't know. Try to stay in as much as possible, and I'm enjoying that. You know, I just stay in. I knit, you know, do things. So I better go. It's probably getting near time to get Scooter up to the vet and get him checked. He's having a lot of trouble with his back legs, but mainly he's just due for his yearly checkup, his rabies shot, and his booster shots, which I'm going to try to avoid. But I really think I need to get him on some kind of a maintenance pain pill, because his little back legs hurt him so much. You wouldn't know he's in pain. You can just tell by what he does and doesn't do. Like, he doesn't want to come up the steps in the back anymore. And I had doggy steps for him to be able to get up on the couch by himself, but he could never come up them. It hurt his legs too much to even hop up that step. So he can't do that. He would follow me when I go upstairs, but he can't go up the steps. So anyway, maybe they'll be able to help him with something. Something that won't make him too sleepy. Okay, everybody, thanks for watching. It was good talking to you all again. Of course, I rambled on about probably nothing most of the time and went way too long. But, you know, it's been a while. So I look forward to hearing from you or seeing your videos. You know, a few of you are still making videos, so that's fun. So anyway, talk to you soon. Thanks for watching. Bye.